at organisms and you look at a coral reef, clearly we're losing more corals than we would hope. And that means that the rates of change in the environment have essentially outpaced the capacity of the corals themselves to adapt. And let's face it, if conditions change fast, you have a couple of options. You move, you adapt, or you die. And they're not adapting fast enough, right? So we're taking these three approaches to accelerate natural selection. They're all fairly natural approaches. They're things that could happen in nature. We're just making sure that they do. How would we do that? Well, what we know is that some corals survive conditions that others don't. So I call these the corals that are like our athletes. They're the ones that are able to really run for longer than the others. We all get that in human populations. Well, I'm looking for the very best performer on the coral reef. And the context for performance isn't a sport. The context is their ability to withstand warm temperatures that kill other corals. So I've got my really good performers, and now we're asking, can we breed them with one another? If we've got a really good performer over here and over here, let's not leave it to chance that their eggs and sperm would meet. Let's bring them together and make sure they do, to make sure we breed the best moving forward. Or we have these great pieces of information coming out that tells us that if a coral survives one stressful set of conditions, somehow when it sees those stressful conditions again, it doesn't really see them as stressful. And you know, for me, that's very intrinsically obvious. Like, I gave my first talk and frankly I thought I was going to faint on stage, right? It was awful. My heart was racing, my mouth was dry, but I pushed through. I gave the talk. People said it went really well. The next time I got on stage to give a talk, it didn't seem quite so difficult, right? So it was within my experience envelope now. I'd done it before, so I could do it again. Well, with corals, we're doing the same thing. We're giving them an experience that will be stressful for them up front, but will fix a memory. So when they see that or experience that thing again, it doesn't feel so stressful, right? That's along the lines of what doesn't kill you makes you stronger. And the last thing that we're doing, which is, you know, really fascinating, and it's really about the interaction of large animals with much smaller living things. And corals are the masters of using the biology of microorganisms to their advantage. Inside their tissues, they are packed with millions of small plant cells that are able to do what all plants do: convert the carbon dioxide that we breathe out, combine that with water using sunlight energy to produce a food molecule and oxygen through the process we all know as photosynthesis. Right? We know that some of these plants are better at feeding their animal than others. And so what we're trying to do is to optimize the relationship and give them the species of plant that will feed them for the longest period of time when the water gets hot. Very simple. But there are also other players, like loads of bacteria all over the surfaces and inside the tissues of the animals, of the corals themselves. And we now know that, like with all large organisms, that which bacteria you associate with can have a fundamental impact on how healthy you are. Now, so say the answer to all those questions is yes, we can breed a strong coral, we can condition or exercise a coral to be as good as it can be, or give it probiotics that help it withstand warmer and more acidic waters. What do we do with them? Well, we have to propagate them very, very quickly, not only here in Hawaii, but we have to do these same experiments with corals in many different places. The ultimate solution to this problem is the reduction of greenhouse gases, is humans stopping fossil fuel burning. But we need to have corals when we've stopped the greenhouse gas emissions. And unfortunately, there's a discrepancy in how quickly we'll be able to moderate the global temperature and the survivability of corals. And so the rates of adaptation have to accelerate moving forward.